I really enjoy building websites that run nicely on all sorts of devices, from phones to tablets to desktop. For me, one of the hardest things to do well is to debug how our site would look on different size screens. I'm sure you know how hard that can be. Hi, I'm Alex Dunlow from the Google Developer Platform team, and I'm going to show you a great feature in the Chrome DevTools called Device Mode. Device Mode makes it super easy to experiment with your content and get your site looking fantastic on any screen. I've saved so much time using Device Mode that I get to spend a lot more time making the perfect coffee. Now, Device Mode lets you try out your CSS media queries, provides a bunch of built-in screen size presets for lots of devices, lets you simulate Retina displays on a non-Retina device, and even has a network throttling feature that lets you simulate slow cell phone networks. So let's take a quick tour through the Device Mode features to show you how to get going quick smart. The first thing you need to do is click this little mobile phone icon in Chrome Developer Tools while looking at your site. As soon as you've done that, you'll notice that your site is displayed in a completely different view. Now's a good time to refresh your browser window so that it gets reloaded with the correct viewport and user agent string settings. It's really easy to remember to do that since you'll be prompted to refresh in a little yellow warning window at the top of the DevTools. Device Mode changes a bunch of different things, like the user agent string is modified to match the device you're simulating, the viewport gets sized to be the same as your target device, the device pixel ratio gets set to the correct value for high DPI displays, your text gets auto-sized if the target does so, and the content window displays mobile scroll bars that look the same as they would on the real target device. Not only that, but touch events get turned on so that your mouse no longer triggers hover events, so no colon hover CSS styles will be applied, and the touch emulation delivers events in the exact same order as on a real device. Now, the main control settings you use in Device Mode are here. You can choose from a number of different device presets simply by selecting one of the drop-down device options. You can also set your viewport to a custom pixel width and height by changing the value shown. It's easy to change the device pixel ratio here, which is also super useful if you want to test that your site's supplying retina-optimized images, for example. You can also easily flip the orientation from portrait to landscape and back with this rotation widget. This makes it so easy to try out different devices and test that your media queries are working as you'd expect. Another really handy feature are these drag handles. Now, using Device Mode, it's not necessary to resize the browser window to see your site in different viewport sizes. You can just grab these handles and move them around to see the size change. Now, what you might have noticed too is that the pixel size displayed in the main control area updates to tell you what the current size is. Now, one thing to note here is if I choose a preset target and then drag one of the sizing handles, it'll reset the preset since we no longer match the size of the target device we picked. Okay, you might have noticed this little icon at the top here as well. What that does is enable the Media Query Inspector. Each of the lines here represents the CSS Media Query pixel breakpoints that the browser's detected in your content. Now, if you click any of those bars, the content window resizes to match the Media Query breakpoint size so you can quickly see how media queries affect layout. This is so quick and convenient, it's fantastic. But even better, you can right-click on them to jump to where the media query is defined in your CSS, just in case you want to do a quick edit of your styles. Now, one of the main differences between a desktop device and a mobile device is the kind of network it's connected to, and Device Mode provides a great feature called network throttling to help simulation of different network connections. Now, as you can see, there are a number of different types of networks supported in the throttling dropdown. So typically, when you're testing load time on your site, you'd use the DevTools waterfall view like this, right? That tells us all about our page load and resource load timings. Now, if I choose a different network speed simulation and reload, you'll see the page get loaded under simulated network conditions. Now, as you can see in our new waterfall, it took a lot longer to load. You can even set no network connectivity to help debug your site if you expect it to work offline. No more turning off of your network required. Now, even better, this network throttling only applies to the currently open tab, so you can continue to use your browser as normal, since only the tab being debugged is affected by the network throttler. Now, of course, since we're simulating mobile devices, chances are they're touch-enabled. Device Mode enables proper touch emulation using your mouse. The content gets sent touch events instead of mouse events. So let's take a look at this text with the Device Mode off. Now, as you can see, when I hover over it, the text changes color. But if I turn Device Mode on, no hover events are sent to the content. More importantly, the order of touch events sent to the content is identical to a real device, which makes it really easy to debug your touch handlers. There are even more controls for you to explore, from emulating hardware sensors that are on a device, changing the user agent style sheet, and plenty more. You can also screencast from a connected device and view the rendered content right inside DevTools. Device Mode brings really, really powerful debugging capabilities inside Chrome DevTools, and it's something I'm sure you can't wait to explore. You'll find the links to our documentation here, and as always, feel free to reach out for more information and feature requests.